Okay, I'm going to take you on a real-time driving tour of Bajo Boquete, the town of Boquete. We're going to come in from the opposite side of what's called the Feria Bridge, the Jaramillo side. And right now we're going to drive right by Boquete's fairground, which is why I chose this. It's on the opposite side of the river. And this is Party Central in January and in November, and a very beautiful spot. If we kept going straight, we'd go up Jaramillo. But we're going to turn, go over the bridge. The bridge is relatively new, a couple of years, over the Caldera River. And into town. And we're going to do some winding around on roads. To the left, shopping. To the right, the Centro de Salud, a public clinic. And directly in front, the Municipal Palace. And we're going to turn here, drive by. On the right is Romero, big market for Boquete. On the left is the Municipal Market, fruits and vegetables. Driving by a distributor for various things here. Little park for children on the left. Malo is an agricultural supply store. Got a doctor's clinic. A bunch of little stores here on this back street that go around. Now we're going to keep on going out of town for a moment. You notice HSBC is here. And on the right side, we're going to pass the Catholic Church. And a taxi goes by. Why we're going to go up this way is because a lot of people don't know how much is out this part of town. This is going toward another town called Los Naranjos. The Zanzibar to the right is a very popular bar. This little Peruvian restaurant here, not many people know. La Posada, very popular restaurant now. I'm going to drive down this little spur, which used to go to a bridge, but now just goes to the Panamonte Hotel and the Panamonte Estates, which are some of the more expensive homes in the Boquete area. Don't really drive into the estates at all, but I'm going to turn around here. The estate should be to the left, and if we drive down this way, you'll see where there used to be a bridge, and we're looking across the river now. And I'm going to turn around because this bridge floated away in a storm about 2 years ago, and although they have basically put rock walls on both sides of the river, they know better than to bother to rebuild the bridge. This was the second time it floated away. Directly in front and on the right is the Panamonte, which is the oldest hotel in Boquete. It's practically 100 years old. It has a wonderful restaurant and a great bar. And now we're going to go back toward the main road. But we're going to continue out toward Los Naranjos. We're going to go right, not left, back into town. You'll notice the ubiquitous taxis in yellow. It's been only 2 years since all the taxis were forced to paint themselves yellow. In the past, anybody could be a taxi, any color car, indiscernible whether it was or not. This on the right is a new hostel. This on the right also is a hostel. Lots and lots of hostels in Boquete. As the world economy soured, more and more hostels have sprung up here. You'll notice the bus stops. They've been building those over the last couple of years. And coming up on the right is part of the Ruiz Coffee Empire. This is their coffee shop. This is also where they roast all the coffee and prepare it for shipping. And the aroma of coffee is strong in the air. Also on the right now is a place called Mi Jardin Su Jardin. And it is a public botanical garden, but it's really private. The owner has left it open for years to the public to enjoy his garden. It is quite beautiful. And we're continuing toward Los Naranjos. We're not going to go all the way there. I'm going to take you to one of my favorite little dives for fried chicken, which is closed right now, and turn around. To the right is a Citon coffee purchasing place where people will bring in their raw coffee and they will buy it by the pound and it will get blended into coffee there. And we're coming up on this fork in the road. And I'm going to turn in here, and if you'll notice on the right, Milky Burger. Milky Burger is the place for fried chicken in Boquete. Here, instead of going on to Los Serranos, we're going to turn back, drive to the center of town and through the center of town. The road here is pretty good, certainly by Costa Rican standards. The roads in Panama are pretty well maintained, with some exceptions, but if it's a main road, it's very well maintained. You saw that yellow van go by, Mark Caligio, that's a school bus. They are private, not public. And most students walk to school here. But if their parents can afford to pay, they get a ride. Get a view of some of the mountains. That's Jaramillo in front of us. Back by Cafe Ruiz. You can see some of the beautiful colors of some of the plants. This is late September. And there's an awful lot in bloom because we've had rain for quite a while now. And this is a morning. So because it's a morning, we have sunshine and no rain. Very, very green part of the world. For me, coming from the desert, this was a very radical transition. You'll notice occasionally orange trees. We're going to do another back road here before we do the center. And we'll point out a few more things to you that not everyone gets to see. On the right side here is Cable and Wireless. And they are the landline provider. They also provide DSL internet. The road up to the right, which we're not going to take, goes to El Salto. Which is laden with coffee farms and others. You get some idea of some of the very typical, more urban setting dwellings here. As we zip by, we're one street off the main street. Come up, and you can see in the front now that blue roofed building is a school. This is the large elementary school for Bajo Boquete. It's speed bump. On the left is a evangelical church. We have tons of churches here. Pick your flavor. If it's Christian in origin, we have it. I'm going to continue back roading for a little bit. Come back up the main road. This intersection, if I went left, we'd go to the main highway. So I'm going to go right, across a little river. And on the opposite side of the river from the main part of town, take this little back road. As you'll notice, a lot of people walk here. Panamanians walk. Expats walk. It's a beautiful and very safe place to walk. Going to do a little more side roading by Amigos de Boquete, which takes care of feeding a lot of children. Trying not to hit anybody. Hola. And down. Take you to the cemetery. It'll take just a minute to walk up here, or to drive up here. You get an idea what a small town Panamanian cemetery looks like. There's no way that you would know all of these things coming into town the first time. But it's an interesting way to look at the world. And we'll do a quick drive through here. You'll notice most everything is above ground. Like Louisiana, it's just too wet to do much of anything else. I'm gonna back out of here. Try not to run over any graves, and continue our short tour. Okay. Again, you get a view of Jaramillo in front of us. We haven't left that perspective yet. And you get an idea how green it is. The first time I came here, my major commentary was I'd never seen so many shades of green. And we're going to continue back on that little side road. Winding down right here on our right is a new bar restaurant, Amigos. Not open yet, but it will be very shortly. And now we're going to turn back to the main road. On the right is where the school buses that are the buses that go back and forth to David are. And directly in front of us is the new not yet open library. This is the first public lending library in Panama, and it was done totally by private donations. As you can tell, they're working on the main highway here. This is part of the widening project of the road between David and Boquete. Gracias. And we're coming into town as if we were coming from David. And we're going to get forced into a detour here. By Sugar and Spice Bakery, which is definitely the place to be. And back onto the road. Now coming up here, we're coming into the more populous part of the town. Stores to the right of us. You're going to notice a huge number of banks. Global is a Panamanian bank. Banco Nacional right next to it is a national bank. Across the street you'll see Banco General, which is a Panamanian bank. Sales office Facelo Paricio. Panama Rafters. Tourism is big here. Big Daddy's, which is an American-owned restaurant. Habla Ya, Explore Ya, Tourism, Casa Solutions, Real Estate, Pool Hall. This is the park, which they're putting a new fountain in on the right side. Market, Chinese market, Mandarin. A block or two of various types of shops, of various types and flavors. Restaurants, shops, grocery stores, pharmacies. Pretty much at this point, anything you actually need, you can get here. You're not going to be able to get everything you want. On the right is Restaurante El Sobrosan, which is by far the most popular restaurant in Boquete. You can still get a good lunch there for about $2. And now we're coming back on that back road that we started on and driving back down toward Romero, back to the bridge, and across. So you can see this is a very active place on a Thursday morning at about 9 o'clock in September 2011. This is one very friendly, very nice town.